This year, as mentioned, has been unprecedented, and the demand for financial advice increased exponentially. On the investment front, we have seen markets really go up and down this year, and the investments have taken a hit, perhaps to the surprise of some of us, including our members.
When's the right time to seek financial advice? Well, the answer's pretty obvious, really. Any time, right now. Just do it if you haven't done it. You also need to make sure that you get advice. For example, if you've got some bonus bond dollars sloshing around in your bank account, earning no interest, if you're considering buying a home, if you're getting near retirement, if you've recently received a bonus or an inheritance, or maybe you won lotto, that's when you need to seek financial advice. The two best ways to get hold of us are to call our 0508 number to make an appointment for a call back or an appointment with an advisor, or email us. As I said earlier, the service is free, the team is qualified. Let us help you maximise your retirement savings.
Mercer is one of the biggest asset managers and investment consultants globally. We have $450 billion under management in our global firm, and $8 billion of that from New Zealand investors. We implement on a multi-manager basis, meaning that we search for the best investment managers around the globe using 150 researchers whose full-time job is to seek out the best managers in each of the regions for each of the investment styles and asset classes. We then select from those managers and create the portfolios that are best for our New Zealand clients. The lockdowns experienced as a result of COVID are those that we've never seen before outside of world wars. And the economic impact was clearly going to be severe. All else being equal, you'd expect the economic lockdown of this magnitude to result in one of the deepest and longest market ruts in history. Fortunately, all else wasn't equal, and governments and reserve banks stepped in to help stimulate the economy. When we look at investments, this is best reflected by looking at a long-term government bond yield. In this case, we've shown the New Zealand 10-year government bond yield. Now, the primary takeaway from this slide is that 10 years ago, if you had bought a 10-year government bond, the government would have been happy to pay you over 5% per annum for holding that bond. Whereas of this morning, if you were to buy the same bond, you would be seeing less than 1% for the duration of that bond.
Mercer believes a responsible investment approach is more likely to create and preserve long-term investment capital. So essentially what that means is we expect responsible investment approaches, or strategies that use these approaches, to perform better than those that don't. Over 2019, Sway's created 7.1 billion cubic meters of drinking water, which is enough to provide water to 3.5 million households. Sway's also created 8.7 terawatts of renewable energy, which is enough to power 850,000 homes, and also avoided 10.2 million tonnes of carbon dioxide from the economy, which is the equivalent of taking 2.2 million cars off the road.
What is likely to drive the markets over the next year is going to be the order in which the vaccine, if it is proven to be successful, is rolled out across the world. That is clearly going to create a lot of difference between economies in terms of how quickly they can exit lockdown, and politics will certainly be at play. What this shows is the growth of $10,000 had you invested 10 years ago in each of the Mercer diversified funds. Somewhat predictably, the high growth fund has outperformed over 10 years the other funds, but it hasn't been without bouts of volatility. Although it has recovered, that downturn, moving from roughly 21,000 in your portfolio to 18,000 had you invested 10,000 10 years ago, must have been quite an extreme situation for many investors, and not many investors could stomach that if they were getting close to retirement. This illustrates why it is so important to choose your strategy correctly. Talk to your advisor and choose the right fund for your situation, your age, and your objectives.
Don't make rash decisions. Take some time, understand what's changed, particularly when it comes to your personal circumstances. Reach out to experts. That is a real balance between risk and return, and also your comfort and acceptance of both. As an investor, experts are there to do the hard work for you.